Welcome back to Let's Play Amberstar Blind. I am the Amethyst Lunatari, the RPG chick, and stuff like that. And we're, well, this guy Orlando is here, and I can't remember. He's doing calisthenics or something. I can't remember exactly why we wanted to talk to him, but I think we find out in here. Or rather, in here. Not sure. If it's not one of these people, then I'll have to watch back an old video or something like that. It might be this guy. Gotta figure out which one is me. Karsten. Oh, Kelvin. Yeah, never mind. I thought that was the same person. Karsten is not Kelvin, and vice versa. That's the wife. She doesn't say anything. Who is telling me about Orlando? Was it you? Yeah. Captain Bricks. He has the wine. Okay, so I need to go to Orlando and talk to him. Wine didn't work. Maybe I can tell him Bricks. I knew there was something. Huh. I guess I can't let him know. Ordered, shipment? Captain? Other than that, I don't know what else to sign. Now, I could try to... Looked like there was something on top of his head. Can I go in here? Not gonna bother saving. Nothing of interest has happened yet. Oh wait, that's not it. Wrong door. No, we're not supposed to be in here, so he might get pissed at us. I don't know. Maybe this will be something which actually we can accomplish. Orlando's wine storage. Now, what formation should group members take up for the next battles? Basically, they're all pretty much around the same armor class and such, but Trazric has 24 hit points. The rest of us have 4. Observe. Cribben is actually the worst at this point. Are there monsters in here? As you enter this hall, it almost takes your breath away. Barrels of wine stand in every corner you can see. Indeed they do. I'm guessing that I actually did turn there. It doesn't look like I'm facing a wall. Well, because I can't move in. Not sure which way we came from. I guess we came from that way. A lot of wine. Not to be served before it's time. That's a door. I'll come back to that. Just go like that so I can see. Yeah. Another door. This place is huge. You're actually moving, believe it or not. Wow. Didn't mean to do that. Wait. One of them might hold something special, you never know. There's gotta be a reason for us to come in here. Especially when the sign says to keep out and he's standing right outside. Wow. Strangely, there is no barrel in this corner. As you examine the wall at the end of the recess, you discover a large block of stone sticking a few inches out of the wall. Well, how do I mess with it? do anything with it. I'll have to come back to that, because... Wait, did I just... Where am I? Yeah, we can totally see that when we're blind down here. Making a note on this. Orlando's Wine Storage. I mean, I don't know how to mess with the brick sticking out. Loose brick. And where are we? We're on the east side of it then, I'm guessing. Sort of, looks like it might go in a long circle here, a big circle, so, to the southeast. Alright. I love this music. Guessing I haven't been here. Just check on that. Right. Yeah, coming along. Big circle here. And there's doors going into the middle, which we have not been through. Guess I'll go quicker if I didn't want to look at everything, but I'm trying to be thorough here. It does go further this way, and we haven't gone this way. Another door this way. Can't even move the map anymore. Gonna save here just in case, because we've explored quite a bit, just in case we run into some kind of monster and die horribly. This way then. Alright. Us to the dead end though. Which way am I headed? Okay. Alright, so that's it. Not much in here. Do I need to be going through? The door is a dead end, I think. Yeah. Too bad I can't move around on the map, you know, while looking at the map. I always like when you can do that in games. So, let's see. Oh! Time for break out another torch. Used up the free ones we have now. Here, the got 10 left. That's a dead end. Going this way, I guess, then? Headed right through that door. We want to make a left. Every corner of this room you see large shelves of which there are many flasks of good wine. It would be funny if we could grab the wine from here and give it to the guy in Twin Lake instead of going through that wine cellar. If we're gonna find anything, but there is more hallways to traverse. That might be it. There is nothing in here. Except we got this here. I'm thinking that's the niche. Yeah. For a knock spell. Let's just see if I can try to, like, have him memorize these spells. I just want to try something, and I know it's not going to work. Alright. Yeah, look, how would we pull that? Obviously, when to pull that, do something with that. I guess we have to use something. No. Unless there's anything else we can actually use. Use knife. It's funny because this game does have a few adventure game elements. Like you could use an inventory item and stuff. It's just... I've yet to successfully use anything. Got nothing here. Alright. Orlando's Wine Cellar, everybody. Through these things like candy. Kind of a waste because we're almost done, but no other way to get out. Now eventually we'll have a spell, light spell or something like that. I want to go through here, I believe. Yes. Me, you did not see me go in there or out of there. No, sir. Now, we have one area left in the city to explore, and then we could head, now that we have all this frickin' money, we can get Gripan, maybe. Well, he's probably gonna need experience points, though. Experience point zero. I'd like to bring him to the Paladins. That's not where I want to be. How the hell do I get out of here again? This way? Thank you. Maybe we don't need a torch to see around the city at night. So the only way we still have to go is down here. Could be Lord Chancellor, that's why. Just gonna save here because we may very well die. Yeah. couple doors. Okay, so this is like approaching the house of the Lord Chancellor. Have I been this way? Nope, this is new. Okay. A big eight on its side. Right. Am I back in the 8 again? Damn it. Get the hell out of here. Is this a dead end too? Crap. I'm getting confounded. So don't go through the door, go this way. Hopefully I'm facing that one. Okay, so there's another sign showing the Lord Chancellor's house. Or a warning of it, in this case. Okay, so this is to the house itself. So I'm actually going to save here, because now that I mapped this stuff out, I don't want to lose that progress. As you enter the house of the Lord Chancellor, you immediately see the large portraits hanging next to the entrance. I do, huh? Now, even though we're in this kind of map, we've got the map, House of Lord Drebin. Yeah, we've got the music corresponding to wandering around in wine cellars. The portraits show the ancestors of the Lord Chancellor. This picture shows a beautiful woman with blue eyes. Below the picture is the name Leonore Drebin. Hmm. Also going to check this flower pot. Portraits show the ancestor of the Lord Chancellor. This picture shows a man with a long white beard and a proud look. The name is shown below the picture, Colwell Drebin. This picture shows a man with red hair and an eye patch. Below the picture is the name Maltor Drebin. Very interesting. This picture shows a woman with a sad expression on her face. Below the picture is the name Fenora Drebin. Okay. So we've got different family members here. Can I look at these barrels? Possibly. Okay. Seeing anything of use. Can I look at this even though it's... I wonder if we can be attacked in this screen. Of course I'm gonna look at other pictures. Although these don't have a description. I'm sure this leads somewhere down. Oh, there's a person! I thought everyone was dead or something. Oh. Wrong icon. As you speak to the woman, she turns toward you and you see her face is red with tears. She sobs, "If you are looking for my husband, the Lord Chancellor, then I must disappoint you. A few weeks ago, one of his experiments in the cellar must have gone wrong. He went into the cellar and then, shortly afterwards, I heard a loud explosion and some horrible laughter. From the day I last saw my husband, I have been trying to reach the cellar, but the door can only be opened with the seal of his signet ring." Alright, so we can ask her about cellar and ring. Experiments. My husband once had two of these seals, but lost one of them several years ago and couldn't find them again. I just have to write this down. Because I got a few things that I might be able to type, like, write in. Alright, and we're... yeah, seals. Ring. Experiments. There might have been a third one, I'm not sure. Perhaps you can help me to find my husband? I am not brave enough to go down into the cellar anymore, now that I hear this inhuman moaning and wailing. Perhaps you would first better take a look around his study in the tower. The staircase to the study is located in our bedroom on the north side of the house. I am too frightened to look there since he has been holding that strange creature prisoner in that glass globe. Globe. Alright, creature. Cellar. Okay, I can't talk about her. I can't talk to her about different things. That was a waste. I wrote all this stuff down for nothing. Maybe I'll have an opportunity to talk to someone else about them. Who knows? Alright. I don't suppose like a globe like this. No. Is there any other way in or out of this place? A note here, perhaps? I came from here. I keep thinking I might be able to look at these pieces of paper or something. Alright, tower, thing and globe up here. Oh, another picture we might be able to look at. Except this plant's probably in the way. I do not need to rest, thank you very much. I can't even look that far. Right. In this room, you immediately notice a large glass globe standing in a recess in the north wall. Something appears to move in the globe. Interesting. What were you up to, Mr. Drebin? Another awesome song. Oh, I cannot understand that. A small figure is imprisoned in this globe. It stares at you with large red gleaming eyes. Through the thick glass, you hear it speaking strange words to you in a deep voice. Kind of sounds like, you know, the backwards of some 80s metal records when you turn the turntable backwards and... Alright, we do not speak demonic. So you can find out what they speak here. Human. Human and orc. Human and gnome. Human and elf. No demon. We do not speaketh demon. Let's see if there's anything else noteworthy up here. I was afraid to come in here, but this is actually okay so far. Anything to be seen here? Oh. On this table, you find a parchment of drawings. Maybe we'll find out. I wanted to take it, actually. I'm used to take being, like, over here. I'll give it to Silk, but I want to trade something with Silk. If anyone's going to lure demonic, I want it to be me. Alright, so... we'll give him the key. Oh, not use. Transfer key to Silk. Transfer piece of paper to moi. Oh, what's that? Is that a portal of some kind? Not sure how to be stepping through that. I feel like saving now. I know, coward. Crystal, 15-1, 876. Hurrah! I have today succeeded in transferring the life force of a minor demon into my homunculus. The beast tried to bite me, and for that reason I locked him in his glass cage. I will show him who is in charge here. Crystal, 27-2, 876. I'm guessing 876 then is the year. I finished the cage in the cellar today. Now everything is ready, and tonight I will try to call up a powerful demon. The only thing which bothers me at the moment is that Damon, as I call the homunculus, has still not accepted me as his master. Well, that doesn't really matter. In the pentagram, no demon can harm me, and the cage in the cellar is strong enough to stop even Browker, the Prince of Hell. Okay, Browker is the demon brother of the demon lord, Torbus, I think is his name? The one that they keep talking about, who was, you know, the reign of Torbus. Okay, so that's it for that. Alright.